Boom, 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 boom. All right, let's put a little polish on this opal, shall we? Okay, I got three gems to show before we get going. And they're not done yet, but they're closer-ish. Like, they're on the home stretch. If I can straighten them and polish them, then we're good to go with two of them. And the third one is that piece of opal that I'm working on right now, trying to get one side polished up so we can see into it. Let's see if I made some progress with it. I got some bad spots out of it. And it is hard. It does not want to polish. I'm going to have to see what the best way to polish opal is. This is cerium oxide. It seems like we got some of the base scratches. No, they're still in there. If I reflect it just right and get that light on it. Like that. Then I can see the scratches. That go deep, and it kind of, that's what stops the ability for us to see down into it. That made complete sense. It's kind of like spelling banana. You just put a B, and then a whole bunch of A's and N's. People know what you're talking about. Khaled, I had an idea. I like the word super. But I don't like soup. So I'm gonna change it to sticker. I'm gonna change super to sticker. Makes too much sense. But I can't say staker because Jamie's vegetarian, so I'll just say wasabi. Wasabi. Yes, that is the opal. That is the opal. I just can't seem to get a very good polish on it, though. Just doesn't want to go down. Yep, I worked the cracks and chips out of it. And I worked the bad spots, like the matrix, out of it. And now it's all clean material, so I've got to just figure out how we're gonna finish shaping it. Oh, I can start to see through that a little bit. Man, it does not want to polish. At least I can see down in there a little bit. There. You see that brown that's coming through? Oh, Colette, on the wheel, I've got 1,000 grit diamond. And that's where I stop. I've got 2,000 grit diamond and 3,000 grit diamond, but they don't do anything. And then I've got cerium oxide PSA discs, which PSA means pressure sensitive adhesive. So a lot of the disc sandpaper is Velcro, but this is the stick-on kind. And so what I did is I took the diamond laps, the 2,000, 3,000 ones, flipped them over to the blank side and stuck the PSA on there. And it burns through it so fast. I mean, it's just like, shh, and it's smooth. So then you gotta scrape all the glue off. And there's other ways to do it, but I just do it by hand. But anyway, yeah, we're starting to get some of the brown to come through. So that's kind of nice. Gotta get it a little bit thinner. And then it'll show a little more. Oh, you can almost kind of see the dull spot over here that I can't quite get sanded out. So that's the opal. Bing. That's the first piece of celestite I cut. It's a nice piece of stone, but it's got a lot of clouds in it. Very cloudy. That's all right. I wanted to start with something simple. It's so soft, Colette. Very, very, very soft. It eats right down. It's surprisingly soft. That opal, man, that's impossible. But this stuff is soft, and it also kind of has me a little worried working with it, like, 'cause I'm, grinding all this powder, keyword powder, off of it. And this is strontium sulfate, which is used to make fireworks powder, gunpowder. Boom. Not necessarily that it just goes boom. I think there's got to be something else with it, and spark and not water, but still, I'm like, is this thing gonna blow up in my hands? Yeah, it's got a lot of problems in it, looking at it now. I mean, you and I are you're getting a look at it before I am. I just polished it up, brought it in here, went live. 'Cause I was like, Jamie asked me if I was gonna go live, and I was like, sure. But here I am, like an hour later. She's like, no, he's not going live. Hour and 15 minutes of cheesh. Well, yep, an hour later. An hour and a half later. Oh, wait a minute. We're missing the stream monitor. How are we gonna play a game? How to polish celestite? People don't, because it's so soft. Fashionable. Well, since I got the gems, that makes me fashionable. But Sure. Yep. We got. It's nice and flare. It's got a good flare and it's blue. I got some nice clean pieces of it, so we'll get some nice gems out of this. I'm just kind of worried about blowing up fireworks and all that. It's just it. Stream Elements just does that. We logged in once and I forgot what my login was, so we've never been able to log in and change it. It is forever logging into my stream and telling people this is a timer. So anyway, yeah, we got this blue gem of strontium sulfate, which is what's used in fireworks. Boom. It's really soft stuff, but I think it's going to make for some nice gems, even though they won't stay polishy. And then, you know, chocolate opal, a little bit farther along. Nice and brown. It's got that color that comes through just the right angle, though. Makes me think it's actually going to look nice once I get it polished. I don't know, because, see, this is all, this light's coming through at a smaller corner of it. Yeah, there we go. It's like a thin corner, so I'll make the rest of the corners thin. This is the point, the other point that makes cutting the gem difficult. At this point, I've got to cut away quite a bit of the stuff that's on it. And so it's like, which one am I going to cut off? I don't know. Got my tank top. Been working on my shoulders. Should probably have like a conservative shirt on though, right? Oh, and the last one, this little green guy, which I'm not sure about. I like it, but it's got like a crack in it, I guess. So I'm kind of like, we're going to have to cut something else. See if I can get a little bit of a face polish on it. Well, the question is, when I cut it in half, what am I going to do with it? And cutting it in half, you got the curve of the blade, the width of the blade that comes out. So you lose a lot there. That's why a lot of people try to split things. I was going to make this one a feature. And maybe we will, but not with that crack in it. I got two other ones we're going to see about. And this one's turning out pretty good. This one I don't know about, though. Anywho, those are the gems of the hour. Wanted to kind of try and get something so that I have something for next week. Actually, I do have something for next week. It's a green appetite half moon. So maybe I'll feature this one next week. Unless I bust it, which I'm always kind of worried about because it's got lines that go sideways. Yeah, there you go. You can see it now. This thing looks great in the sun. I should definitely make this a feature. I mean, I took the time to work on it and everything. I like it. It's a great gem. We gotta feature it. Yeah, that's what we'll do. That'll be next week's feature. But we'll keep working on the other gems in the meantime. And hopefully I can get a chance to cut this garnet. which kind of looks like a piece of prehnite, but garnet grows in like soccer balls. And so I'm like, it like when it goes in the soccer ball, it like it grows outward. And so this has like a point in the middle that grows out, kind of like prehnite does. See how it's like there and then it goes outward and it's all roundy. But you see that red that's coming through? I'm thinking that if I polish it up, we'll get that to come out. I think that'd be a really beautiful gem. Maybe there's a big crack in it, who knows? It'd be nice to see. The green moon. And it's got this point on it, so we can go poke. Cheers. Let's go ahead and start some game, shall we? Wait, the cracks don't always crack. Cracks don't always crack. Spiralin made it. And yeah, there we go. I yep, just saw her. Cut it in half. Character. Stunning. The green moon. The cracks don't always crack. Use that for a joke. Not, nope. It's not catching up. Not this brain. Not at this hour. Wish I could though. So. Where were we? Where were we? We flew the boat. I remember that. So we'll just fly the boat one more time for good measure. Blow up cheeks. I hope that made you laugh. So, how is the stream going? Is it going good? We're off to a good start.
Navigator, light the engines. Credit savings and loan, we shall be moored no longer. We are away.
Yeah, not the strontium sulfate. Actually, I don't think strontium is recommended for plants anyway. Maybe it is. I'll have to look at that again.
We're all the sense got.
There's sulfur in there, so that could be good.
Hey, there's something you...
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe. Lay that pistol down. Pistol back in my...
Oh, the... Yeah. That boat. It's jumping from building to building. Oh, wow. Yeah. The penetration laser.
Pistol packing mama, lay the thing down before it goes off and hurts somebody. Oh, she kicked out my windshield and she hit me over the head. She cussed and cried and said I'd lied and she wished that I was dead.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama, lay that pistol down.
You need?
From deep down Texas way. We got no pals. They don't like the way we play.
What is it?
Glad you're with us.
Trio, but you'll see my sister Cleo. She's a terror, make no error, but there ain't no license fair.
Return to Virgil.
Lay that pistol down, babe.
Okay, we got, yeah, we gotta go see Virgil. Yeah, I was talking to Jamie about penetration earlier. Did I mention the double beds? I think we were talking about how all the pillows were thrown.
Time and a place for that, and neither's here.
Okay, we're good to go. Don't do your knitting anymore. Whatever he said, that was, yeah, good stuff. Gonna store a little bit of junk.
Mm-hmm.
no, I'm out of bullets.
We're gonna have to go on a bullet getting mission. Like, specifically. That's gonna be fun. Nuclear waste. In chemtrails is the nuclear.
Truth is stranger than fiction. Well, you know the radio plays that I air sometimes, occasionally in the right order. You know the Silver Shroud.
Hmm.
It sounds like someone takes them really serious.
Junk, not stuff. You guys keep talking about my junk.
About sightings of the Silver Shroud in the Commonwealth.
Oh, what's so great about it? Actually, I do know what's great about it. It's my junk.
Anyway, I guess.
Oh, man. We're not going to shoot a bear. Come on. There's a tree in the house.
Cleaning up the town?
There's a tree in the house.
One of the residents, a guy named Kent, whose name I should not be saying on the air, he was supposedly rescued by the Shroud. Or at least that's what I heard. So now there's a superhero out there defending justice, I guess.
Yeah, Jamie, we were talking.
People that hopefully deserve it. Uranium fever is on next, and well, I'm pretty sure enough time has gone by that we don't find any more in this subject.
Oh yeah, I was gonna stop by our other place and then go over to Virgil's. No, stuck on something I can't see. I need to turn the brightness up. What were we talking about? We're talking about the word super and how I like the word super, but I don't really like soup. So we're changing it to sticker. But we can't call it sticker because steak's not good, so we're going to change it to wasabi. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Nice little upstairs area. Summertime village. You know, I invested in putting that sign up there, but I never get to see it unless I force myself to. I like putting the signs where I'm, like, walking by it, you know? So, let's see if we can kind of jog out to where Virgil is. You guys are probably familiar with a lot of it, but basically it's a nuclear wasteland. That's why we need to take a bullet mission and get some more of these 308 rounds. Because that's how we do it. What? No. You gotta stop saying these things. You're like, bye forever. Blue Kool-Aid soup.
See a lot of folks at their worst.
Actually,
Look who it is.
Actually, wow. Really got good aim with that cocktail.
Not that it's an option.
He's got great aim with that cocktail, man. Hit the bug right on. Okay, so actually I should take that back because mostly I was trying to make a joke, but like, you know, I'm used to like soup is water. Who wants water? That's like the leftover stuff from the good stuff. It's like once all the goodies have been taken out, the only thing that's left is the soup. But actually, all the good stuff is like, that's where all the good stuff is in the soup. You gotta drink that soupy yum. Oh, there's a downed plane. Check that out. Well, there it is. There's the plane. My soups need a spoon. A fork. Broccoli cheese soup. Oh, actually, like, I was like, why does broccoli cheese get such a bad rap? Because broccoli cheese is amazing. I mean, and cauliflower cheese soup, give me that cheese, baby. Give me that cheese. Oh wow, there's the wings to it. This plane's so big that they have people sit on the wings. Oh, look at that. Goodies. Flight data recorder. Wonder who we're gonna take that to. That seems like something that we need to take to somebody. Anyways. This is apparently the result of a nuclear bomb storage facility exploding. Eddie. Veggie broth, like tortilla soup, ramen. What is pho? I like it nice and wet. Well, I will say, make a good argument. I do like it nice and wet. Not really into dry soups. Just thick soups. Like a thick soup. I like a gravy soup. Gravy and cheese and like, I think it's kind of funny that, like,
something out there.
Yes, we're not a... Dang. This thing doesn't want to die. Yikes.
But too much of that stuff has fallen into my...
Oh yeah, well actually I did. He's got good guns, but I got better guns. I got the penetration laser.
I know that someday that sun is bound to shine.
I don't wanna go over by the scorpions. We gotta heal up a little bit, foist. But when I think of you, another shower starts into each life. Some rain must fall. Drink gravy. Oh, I love gravy. Yeah. See, that's the thing, is that it's chilly enough for soup. Oh man, soup. Yeah, soup will warm you up on a cold day. Mm-hmm, I can see that. Instead of drinking, like, soda pop, drink soup. You know? Hot soup. Lots of energy.
You're listening to, Diamond City Radio. If you're listening at all. Here's some Betty Hutton, if you were waiting to hear it. I mean, whether you were or not.
Okay. That's one of my jokes is that, and it's not really a joke, is that I have an American diet. I live on dips, sauces, gravies, dressings, glazes, toppings, sprinkles, and dips, sauce, gravy, dressings, glazes, and sauces. Wait, no, dips, dips, sauces, dressings, gravies, glazes, dips, sauces, gravies, dip, sauce, gravy, dressing, glaze, there's another one I'm not thinking of, toppings, sprinkles, and seasonings, but there's another one I'm missing. We'll all need to get some food soon. Peanut butter. Mm-hmm. Yeah, if it's a like a topping or a seasoning, that's mostly like, I mean, it's like the whole purpose of a bun. You can do neat things with a bun. Like I've been having croissants, and you put butter on it and toast it for like a burger bun. But it's still just a sandwich handle. Who here loves pita pockets? Right? Jamie, you gotta like pita pockets because it has one of them weird words in it. Pita? Yeah. Always loved pita pockets ever since I was little. Oh, we went way past it. Okay, we went around it. Makes him from scratch. He's a demon. He is a devil. He is a dog. Wonder how Virgil's doing. I think he converts back to a human at some point.
Nice.
Energy weapons, plus 5 crit damage. I like that.
Battles are won with fists, wars with wits.
Hi.
Wasn't sure I'd see you again. You managed to get what you need?
I just went out for a little stroll. Thought I'd stop back and say hi.
It's a good thing your survival and my humanity aren't at stake. Otherwise, I might be annoyed by your attitude. But, fine. I shouldn't have doubted you'd come back. You did get rid of Kellogg after all. Not too much of a leap to take down a courser. How'd you manage to get it decoded?
The railroad?
The railroad helped me.
Oh god, those kooks. I would have expected they'd be too busy trying to liberate vending machines or setting computer terminals free or... Sorry. They just have something of a reputation. You're not the only one who's been busy. I did the best I could. From memory and things I've overheard through the years, came up with some schematics for you. Wasn't easy. These hands are ridiculous. Fine motor skills have gone to shit. Here's the simple explanation. You need to build a device that will hijack the signal the Institute uses to teleport coursers and send you instead. You know the craziest part of the design? That classical music station. That's the carrier signal for the relay. All the data's on harmonic frequencies. You've been hearing it all along. I want to be clear that this isn't my area of expertise. I was bioscience, not engineering or advanced systems or anything.
Your confidence is staggering.
I'm just saying, I can't guarantee it'll
work. Something funny.
But if you can build this device and make use of that code, you should be able to override the signal from the Institute's relay. Can you? I mean, can you build it? You have people that can help. This is a lot for one person, even you.
This device, this will get me into the Institute?
Yes, if built correctly. And please get it right. You have to make it in there for both our sakes. And don't you forget our agreement. I've helped you as best I can. If you make it in there, you find that serum. It's my only hope for ever being normal. So you find it. Now go on. Take these and get to work. You do whatever it takes. Call on whoever you know to help you.
You got it.
What the hell aroma is that?
They cut them up and toast them in the oven and use them in dips, sauces, gravies, dressings, glazes. They dips, sauces, gravings. I'm gonna type it. I think that's everything.
Everybody might be listening now. I guess I hope that's a lot of people, but regardless.
Jellies. So we could include jellies too. Fillings.
Billy, I'm told,
good old filling.
I don't quite know how that happened. I guess it doesn't really matter. So this kid, Billy, I guess he wound up running into, thanks to the vault dweller,
Dang. That is way too many bullets going into that.
I know that. Well, it isn't always great out there in the world, so...
Just emptied, like two thingers.
Anyway, back to the music, I guess. Do you know someone who gambles? Then maybe this will make you laugh. Or...
Pudding. Pudding. Your grandma plays the numbers. They don't damage easily, do they? Well, you know, with melty cheese, I would say that's getting a little too specific. Because melty cheese could be a topping, a filling, or, you know, cheese sauce. But yes, I live on melty cheese. What is faux, by the way? Is that faux real? Jamie, you gotta ask a restaurant that. Is that faux real? Or is that imitation faux? Legendary ones are great because they give you special stuff. What did this one give us? Ooh, a lucky hunting rifle. Critical shots do double damage, and the critical meter fills 15% faster. That's lucky.
Anything useful?
Why does tofu taste like toe? Foo. That's really dumb. Oh yeah, the scorpions. The only thing worse than the scorpions are the stingwings. Remember where I was saying that, like, dude was a real good shot with that Molotov cocktail? Those things, if they get close to you, they spin in a circle. And they're faster than you are, so that. We're gonna go on a bullet buying mission. Tortilla soup, right? Does that mean that you can also make pita soup?
Means a lot to me that you made the library a safer place. Thanks again. Now you're here to trade.
Just browsing for now.
Looking's not as good as having honey.
Oh yeah, I wanted to do that.
You're bad. Can't get enough looks at this lovely figure of mine. No? Guess you'll just have to shop then.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Everything's guaranteed to last. Until it doesn't.
Oh, look at that. 40 bullets. That's great. And 41 of those. Man, we are just winning already. I think that's really all we need. Yeah, we got quite a few of everything else. The giant hand woman. Oh yeah. And the robot woman.
Buying. Even a girl with an arsenal full of weapons needs to make a living after all.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Each weapon tested on someone who deserved it.
Sea creatures are more hesitant to attack you. Anyways. I try to keep at least three of everything on hand, that way if we come across a deal where somebody needs something, then we have it. The joke robot
sort
woman.
Note, I guess, from a sponsor here in Diamond City.
Okay, we got bullets, so that's a start. Not a lot.
Commonwealth weaponry.
But it's a start.
It's a dangerous world out there. Protect yourself, protect your family. Here's Uranium Rock, a song about people getting rich by finding uranium. That worked out real well.
We get a shop somewhere, don't we?
I'm joking. Just joking. It went poorly.
Yeah, the beach. We can buy there. Yeah. We can buy at the beach. If the bullet salesman's on duty. Boom, 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 boom.
Hey, do something for you?
Oh, Colette, I am so glad you're here. So glad you're here. Okay. I hope you can see this. I hope you can see that. It is called the extended napalmer. Let that sink in. It weighs 25 and a half pounds, and I have been carrying it around specifically for you. Okay, but we gotta lighten our load first.
I'll take a look, sure.
Let me know what you'd like.
Nice. I like the weapon shop, you know? I got the crates, I got weapons laying around. I got the mine collection up there. And a little turret sitting out front. Just seems appropriate, right?
You ain't been up to see Grey Garden, you should go. Whole place is run by robots.
I built that place. Ooh, before we leave here, we gotta All right, we'll do that, Colette. But before we go, we gotta give some of our attire to somebody, cause we got a helmet. Oh, I can see the boat up there. You see the boat, Colette? On the skyline?
Crazy calls sure I'm crazy, crazy in love. Am I? Like the wind that shakes the bough, he moves me.
Oops, wrong button.
Yeah. Yeah, I keep entering into workshop mode. We'll come back to that. Especially since I don't have a lot of fuel for it. Okay, let's give away some attire, shall we?
Just looking to trade a little.
Sure thing.
I just want to trade a few things.
Go ahead.
Oh, the cane thing fell over. That's too bad. It's always gonna make a deli there. I think we have a deli. Shoppers? Cool. I like it too. I think you can get to the water in 5 to 10 years. No, I think it was 5 to 10 more tries. They figured 200 years they'll be in the water. Or no, maybe it was 500 years, something like that. It was ridiculous. Got anything, Carla?
Carla.
Hey there. Trading?
I'll take a look. Sure.
You break it, you buy it.
Safe and all. Don't forget to take your safe and all.
Anyway, it's, well, it's something to think about, I guess. This, I hope you like this song. It's, Butcher Pete by Roy Brown. Wait, unless it's Roy Brown. No, it's Butcher Pete by Roy Brown.
Oh yeah, we didn't build it over here because nobody ever goes over there. We built it on the way into town.
Yeah.
That's what we did. See the toys in the deli and the fashion store? It's all over here. I should have turned it though. So you can see the fashion store here and the toys in the deli here when you're coming down this way. Anyway, there's the deli so far. Okay. Let's go to the drive-thru. No, he still has his jacket. I gave him the sweater vest. And then I made him put it on. But his jacket is still in his inventory. I didn't take it, although I could, and he wouldn't care.
World is bigger than strong.
If you work, you eat. It's as simple as that.
Can we trade a few things?
Okay.
See, now I can take her traveling leather coat and have a spaceman walking around.
Identity confirmed. This.
So many humans, not many superheroes.
Oh yeah, strong. He's hilarious, isn't he? Wonder why that's not on. Anyway.
Damn Raiders. Hit us hard.
So much walking.
Baby, 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 I'm a fool about love.
Maybe I should go to school. Want to do more fighting?
Yeah, I need to set up the bullet store here so I can buy bullets, huh?
Super mutants kill everything.
I don't really have the stores set up. Hangman's Alley? I don't even know where that is.
She said, "No, I'm not Joe, my name is Harry. Worry, 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 worry."
It's in the middle of the city, right? Castle. On our way to the castle.
Keep a knocking, but you can't come in. Keep a knocking, but you can't come in. Keep a knocking, but you can't come in.
Boom, 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 boom.
You're tuned to Radio Freedom, voice of the Minutemen. Attention, Minutemen. We've just gotten word that a settlement is in trouble.
Raiders at Summertime Village. All right, let's go hit Summertime Village.
Yes, I'm here to help. What's going on?
There's a group of raiders that won't leave us alone. Stealing our food and supplies, threatening us if we can't give them what they want. We know where they're coming from, but we can't stand up to them ourselves.
Don't worry. I'll take care of those raiders for you.
I hope so. We didn't know what to do.
Looks like I better get rid of a little bit of radiation, huh? Let's make short work out of this, right?
Unless you're hounding for a green suntan, I suggest we get a move on.
What the fuck was that?
Me.
Here's a...
Elma!
You know that big ship? The one that's on top of a building downtown? Yes, that ship.
Oops.
So I've avoided
the wrong
more than
not that it's an option.
Already avoid the rest of downtown. Which should already be, I don't know, a lot.
Look who's back.
It's just in a different place now. It's now, now it's stuck in the side of another building downtown.
He's talking about the boat.
Expect from an old ship, or really any ship, actually, but, life in the Commonwealth! Closer to the mic. Stupid! This is Johnny Mercer singing about personality. If you got it, you should appreciate it, because it's not necessarily common. Johnny Mercer.
Madam has the cutest
thinking.
And think of all the books about the Barry books. What was it made of? A dose of Marie. She had a well developed personality.
No sign of him now.
Someone's coming.
Hey, who's there?
I don't think we're alone. Don't underestimate us again. You're gone for good? Just when I thought we were getting along.
Get him once.
Keep your eyes open. I think this asshole's using a stealth suit.
When you turn up, you're dead.
When I think of you, I...
Got it.
That's cool.
Okay.
I wish more people could see this. Remind them what it's all about.
Most folks are just looking for a hand.
What do you need, General?
Good news. If you, haven't already seen it, which I did, so I know it's true, but not just something that I overheard. Nick Valentine is back in town. He was gone for a while. Some people who are totally not me.
You need a minute?
Well, they thought he might be dead. Or destroyed, whatever. Anyway. Glad you're back, Nick. Even though we never really talked.
This is Radio Freedom.
Next is Bob Crosby.
Wait a minute, what?
That's one of my top five Crosbys.
Hi. What do you need, General?
Oh, man. I always wanted to say that.
I have plans here to build a signal interceptor that can get me inside the Institute.
The Institute? Why in the world would you want to mess around with them?
They kidnapped my son.
Damn. That's some bad business. Even for them.
We'll give you whatever help we can. Don't worry about that. Now, assuming you could build this thing, what exactly does it do? Did you know the Institute has a teleporter? They call it the Molecular Relay. Teleportation? For real?
Wow. That would explain a lot about how the Institute manages to operate. If anyone can make heads or tails of those plans, it'd be Sturgis. I haven't found anything yet that he couldn't build or fix. I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
Oh, snap. I was gonna save it. My mistake. I was gonna save it before that.
That's a lot of background noise.
Nope, just to the pre-teleportation. That's what I wanted to do. Double save. I'm gonna go see what the railroad does about this. Tinker Tom will probably build something. The other option we have is to talk to the talk to the Brotherhood about it.
Tinker Tom's been looking for you.
That last song? Okay.
Do you need something?
All right. Now be careful with that gun. Real careful.
What?
Hey, so, there's this bit of news some real that, it might
the
interest
boy's
you.
Been working on it.
Tiny if not, little hang on a minute, a and I'll go back kid. To the music that we usually play. If you hadn't heard, I mean, I guess most people know this, but maybe someone didn't, that the Green Tech building was where those mercenaries...
You say? Yeah, man, well, probably. The math looks tight. Whoa! Terry? Where's Terry? Too much nitroglycerin. Back to the drawing board. Dez has given me clearance to set up my atmospheric sensors. Finally, I can prove that the Institute is terraforming the Commonwealth. Eat that, Carrington.
Yeah, we don't want to start that mission yet.
Desdemona.
Do you need something?
All you need to know is there's a machine that can get me inside the Institute.
So that's what the Courser chip was all about. You needed that frequency, I take it. Why? What does this machine do?
Did you know the Institute has a teleporter called the Molecular Relay?
We've spent dozens of years and too many good agents' lives only to discover not a goddamn thing. And now we have the answer, thanks to you. Teleportation. That the Institute could build something so... But we've got work to do. This is our top priority now. I want Tinker Tom to help you in any way possible to get this device built.
You really walk the Freedom Trail. By yourself.
Let's see what the Brotherhood says. The radio station, a babe. Oh, yeah, cheeky babes. Okay, we'll go up to the to the airship. We'll just fly up there. It's more fun to fly. Oh,
hey,
call it
out. Hi.
Actually, let's hear his update.
You know that big ship? That, the old sailing ship? The one that's on top of a building downtown? Yes, that ship.
Well, I would, avoid it if I were you. I mean, more than you'd already avoid the rest of downtown. Which should already be, I don't know, a lot.
I mean, it's still there. It's just in a different place now. Now it's stuck in the side of another building downtown. Not,
Very fluid with you. That's what I would expect.
Or any question for any ship.
Any ship. Life in the Commonwealth!
From that there to up there.
vents are replaced.
So, we'll go see what this guy says about it.
Elder Maxon.
I care about them, you know. The people of the Commonwealth.
Care about them? I thought we were preparing for war.
The Brotherhood is here to prevent a war by starting one of our own. The difference is, our war won't reduce civilization to ashes.
What do you want from me?
I want you to start taking responsibility for this planet. To start making a difference. And from what I've read in Paladin Dance's reports, you've already begun that journey. Seeing as he's one of my most respected field officers, you couldn't get a better recommendation. Therefore, from this moment forward, I'm granting you the rank of knight. And, befitting your title, we're granting you a suit of power armor to protect you on the field of battle. Wear it with pride.
I'll do my best to live up to it.
I'm certain that you will. In any event, once you're finished becoming familiar with the Pridwin and my staff, report to the flight deck for your new orders. Welcome aboard the Pridwin, soldier. Make us proud.
Okay. There's actually a lot more to that, but we're supposed to talk to him about the thing.
Elder Maxon, I have a set of plans to build a signal interceptor to get me inside the Institute.
An intriguing proposal that I'll have to seriously consider. However, before I allow any of my soldiers to breach the Institute, careful preparations need to be made. In the meantime, I need you to follow my orders and remain patient.
Why wait when we have a way inside right now?
I appreciate your enthusiasm, but I need you to view this from my perspective. I'm not willing to risk the lives of my soldiers based solely on a set of crudely drawn plans. Give us time to validate the information you've discovered. Then when the time is right, I promise you, I'll do everything in my power to construct that device. You're dismissed, Knight.
And then...
plating integrity looks good.
Elder Maxon?
Take some time to familiarize yourself with the ship. Then meet me on the flight deck for your mission.
Proximity sensor's green. Getting a 3-second pingback. Congratulations on the promotion, Knight.
Thank you. Wonder where Jeanette is. I haven't seen her in, like, 3 streams. I figured she'd be by for the bottling machine stream. I was doing some math on the bottler. What is that in? Well, I guess we must have to wait for him, and then he talks about it later or something. Back to the boat. Oh, okay, yeah, so I was doing some math on the bottling machine, and I kind of got, like, some ideas of... Remember how... Okay, so you remember we were getting it to do, like, 2%, and then the next couple of times, it was a different amount? Let me refresh. Okay, there we go.
Hey, at least it's honest work.
Make a move, and I'll end you, Wastelander.
This is Diamond City Radio, and I'm, you know...
Oh, yeah, Colette, if I give people anyway, armor, then I can take their clothes away, and then they walk around with undies. it's kind of funny.
If you cared so much, but anyway, you with her in the first place?
What I did is I did the railroad, or the Minutemen, the first time through.
Crawl out through the fallout, baby, when they drop that bomb. Crawl out through the fallout with the greatest of aplomb. When your white count's getting higher, hurry.
Yeah, we'll do Tinker Tom's route, because, I'm not familiar with that.
Tom wants you for something.
Do you need something?
Okay, so anyway, what I was saying about the bottling machine is that I was doing some math on it, and remember we had 2% deviation and then 10% deviation, or, well, 9.5% deviation. It had to do with how quickly I was pouring the water in. So the slower water meant less siphon. So, oh yeah, I got a whole town. Like that, I think, like, three or four girls, but anyway, like, I think I gave them dresses, so that they're not in their undies anymore, but anyway, it was just by chance, but then, you know, gave them all nice dresses. And built a shopping mall. Still working on part of it. But anyway, I was doing some math on the siphon, and it's kind of interesting. I was reading about, like, scientific exploration and tests into the siphon phenomenon. People are like, oh, it's molecular bonding. No, it's atmospheric pressure. No, it's vacuum. No, it's gravity, etc. And basically, it got me to figure out where we need to put the vent drops and the anti-siphon drops, and then we can go ahead and increase the flow. But I was thinking maybe I want to get some different size tubing. Maybe I should just rebuild the machine a little bit so that it has dual drops. And I was kind of thinking about that today, so I got to think about that a little bit more. I really like this Celestine gem. It's a nice little blue color, soft blue. I'd like to shape some more of it. Anyways.
All right. Now be careful with that gun. Real careful.
What? Why, Tinker?
Because the ammo should have some real oomph to it. Me and the boys been working on it. Tiny little package, but a hell of a big kit.
Is it safe?
You say safe? Yeah, man. It's probably. The math looks tight. Whoa! Terry? Where's Terry? Oh, yeah. Too much nitroglycerin. Back to the drawing board.
Desdemona.
Do you need something?
I have plans here to build a signal interceptor that can get me into the Institute.
So that's what the Courser chip was all about. You needed that frequency, I take it. Why? What does this machine do?
The Institute uses teleportation to get in and out. The Interceptor can hijack their signal and send me instead.
We've spent dozens of years and too many good agents' lives only to discover not a goddamn thing. And now we have the answer, thanks to you. Teleportation. That the Institute could build something so... But we've got work to do. This is our top priority now. I want Tinker Tom to help you in any way possible to get this device built.
Ready to hand over the plans? This is the big one.
Here you go. Let's see what we need.
Hold on. Who wrote this? Some kid with a crayon?
She.
Must have been a real big kid.
Oh, man!
Molecular transmission via encrypted RF waves? Those Institute eggheads are crazy.
And you can divert the signal using a heavily modified relay interception. Like a pirate broadcast, you know? That's intense.
Can you build it, Tom?
The plans cover all the high-end egghead shit, but they're missing a ton of engineering details. Filling in the gaps will take time. This bit here, the stabilized reflector platform, just needs some high-grade metal. Easy. By the time you finish that, I'll have the rest done.
What's it gonna take to build it?
We can scrounge up the platform components you need. No problem.
But where to build it? It's gonna need some serious space. This baby's big.
It should fit over at Mercer's safe house. Pam's already given that place her full blessing. I'll flag some runners to deliver the components there. Dez has given me clearance to set up my atmospheric sensors. Finally, I can...
Okay, apparently we gotta build this table thing, and I also need to get a drink. But, you know, I think we can build this table thing down here. I'll just stick a nuclear generator just, you know, right out here in the beach. Any old place on the beach. That's good enough. Who cares if it floods? Back to Tinker.
You got what it takes to go far with us. I can tell.
Hey there.
You got the platform built yet? Tick tock, tick tock. I'm waiting for the good news.
I did it. The platform's constructed.
And I filled in the blanks on the blueprints. We can actually build this crazy thing. The science of this monstrosity is wild. But fortunate for us, the ingredients pretty common. But there's three specialty items that I just can't grab from our safe houses. You find those, and we'll knock down the gates of hell.
Hmm. How's the interceptor actually work?
Then let me impart some science to you. We got four main parts. Need a control console to input the code and process your biological information. No problem. Easy. Second up, a relay dish. That's the bit that intercepts the teleporter signal, man. A molecular beam emitter to, scramble your molecules up for the transmission. After that, just wire everything together on the same power grid, and boom! This thing's gonna suck up juice like a blood bug on a Brahmin.
Thanks, Tom. I'll find them.
I don't doubt it for 1 minute. After you get the gettables, meet me at the build site.
Tom needs you. Keeps bugging me about it. You really walk the freedom trail by yourself.
Word
make
is,
sure you never
Diamond
follow.
City is under opposition
all
control.
Rest.
Terminal's gotta be somewhere.
All along, the bastards have been teleporting personnel to the surface. Is there nothing they can't do?
Hey, man. Need help with the signal interceptor? This thing is gonna be huge. We'll finally learn about what the Institute's really up to, man.
How are we going to build this control console?
Every last one of your atoms and molecules need to be categorized, then translated into a pure digital feed. Hey, that's a crazy mashed-up combo of biology and computer science. Genius, right? Hospital's got the equipment you need.
Tom's gonna be in heaven on this job. Status report.
We got activity, Des. Not sure how long before it peaks.
The Institute is a huge unknown. Before we can make any plans, you need to do something. What I'm about to tell you is the most closely guarded secret the railroad has. It's time you learn about Patriot.
Patriot? Seriously? Who chooses these code names anyway?
Your sarcasm is noted. There's a man. Or woman, we're not sure.
I wanted something funny. Wow, that was a long load. I can't believe I didn't save that. I screen printed, but I didn't save, huh? That's what I need is a drink. That'll help. Let's do that. We'll build it again, and then we'll do the drink thing.
Okay.
Be right back.
Okay. Let's see what's up.
Desdemona.
Status report.
We got activity, Des. Not sure how long before peaks.
The Institute is a huge unknown. Before we can make any plans, you need to do something. What I'm about to tell you is the most closely guarded secret the railroad has. It's time you learn about Patriot.
Patriot?
There's a man. Or woman, we're not sure, inside the Institute, who helps synths escape to freedom. Dozens of synths owe him their lives. We don't know his name. We've never had a way to contact him. So we gave him the code name, Patriot. If your plan works, and you're able to get inside the Institute, we need you to make contact.
How can I contact him if you know nothing about him?
Patriot devised a method to communicate with us one way. The plan hinges on us using this method to close the loop and contact him back.
Okay. I'll do my best.
Tom's encrypted a message for Patriot's eyes only. Once he sees it, he'll contact you. Until you make contact, and probably after, you need to stay in their good graces. You need to infiltrate them. Can you do that? Can you be our agent on the inside?
How do I infiltrate them?
You're going to have to sell them a lie. It's best to stick as close to the truth as possible. And you're going to have to think on your feet. We don't know what's waiting for you. If you make it at all.
Bring it on.
You can do this. I believe in you. Stand on the platform and I'll give you the holotape. Just plug it into any Institute terminal and wait for the reply. Tom, talk to me.
Booting up something out of the Commonwealth yet?
This frequency is only going to work once. You know who doesn't make the same mistake twice.
So stand still. You gotta lock in all those molecules of yours. Hopefully we won't miss any. There's only, you know, 60 trillion of them. All right, feeding our baby some juice. Let's see what she's got.
Take this holotape. You need it to contact Patriot.
Oh, man, don't worry. That's all part of the plan.
Tom, do whatever you can to gain their trust. Lie. Tell them what they want to hear. Make up a cover story and sell it.
Come on, I think I got it. Establishing lock on the Institute signal.
Just get all the information you can. About synths, about the Institute's plans. Find their weaknesses. If we can disable or destroy the Institute, we may have to do it. You jack that holotape into any terminal, and Patriot will make contact. He has to.
Got the aura! We got it!
Find a way to save them. Nobody else can.
Now!
I wondered if you might make it here. You're quite resourceful. I'm known as Father. The Institute is under my guidance. I know why you're here. I'd like to discuss things with you face to face. Please, step into the elevator.
Yeah, Khaled, I've always kind of figured that teleportation might actually be possible. Not necessarily organisms, but like materials.
Broken.
I can only imagine what you've heard. what you think of us. But I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression. Welcome to the Institute. This is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people, the work we do. For over 100 years, we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials, a shared vision of how science can help shape the future. It has never been easy. And our actions are often misinterpreted by those above ground. Someday, perhaps, we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now, we must remain underground. There's too much at stake here to risk it all. As you've seen, things above are unstable.
That's all just opinion. There's a boy on an old Western show with a line that applies. He says, "That's what you say."
I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that can wait. You are here for a specific, very personal reason. You are here for your son.
Jammed. Only opens with a key. Sean?
Huh?
Sean?
Huh? Yes, I'm Sean.
Sean, I've been looking for you for so long.
Who are you?
Sean, it's me. I'm your dad.
Father, what's going on? What's happening?
Those bastards, they took you from me.
What's going on? Father? Father!
Sean, open the door.
I don't know you. Go away. Father! Father, help me! There's someone here, help me!
Damn it. Sean, open the door!
Father? Father, help me! He's trying to take me! Father? Father, help me!
Sean. S923, recall code Cirrus. Fascinating, but disappointing. The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a prototype, you understand. We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli. Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew. I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
So, Colette, I'll kind of just fast forward through some of this because I'm going to wrap up the stream and we'll pick up the details later. But basically, he's a robot. This guy...
This really is a matter of importance.
This guy claims to be the stolen baby. He says that after the baby was stolen, we were refrozen for about 65 years. And now that's our baby. That's our son. It's the old guy. And that's not necessarily true, because when we found Kellogg, Kellogg said, I don't know what the old man wanted him for. So where's the old man? Right, so it doesn't really make sense. But anyway, where were we? Shaboom-ba-boom. Oh, I guess that did work. That's not what I wanted to leave on, but, yeah, we'll just kind of leave on this. Going down the hall. So eventually...
But that can wait. You are here for a specific...
We'll pick that up next time. There's like... so much going on in such a game... that it makes me think, you know, if I'm going to put this much brain power forward into weighing all these options, I might as well be actually working on something useful, because I'm not playing a game to make decisions. I'm playing a game to relax my brain. If I'm going to use my brain, I might as well make it useful. Anyway... I'll see you on the next one, and we'll have an update on the bottling machine and that opal.